In this video, I'm going to talk about deep winter solar greenhouse insulation and how to install it on the most simple greenhouses. Basically, we're going to make what's called a solar greenhouse to get you through the long cold winters, but as economical as possible using supplies you can buy online or at most any hardware store. Simple Tech, practical, effective technology. I made this channel to experiment with simple technology for agriculture and energy. Clicking the subscribe button tells YouTube's algorithm you want to see more videos like this. Click the subscribe button now. There are three things to consider with insulation when constructing an economical insulated solar greenhouse for deep winter use: outside, inside, and the floor. First is the outside walls. For an economical solar greenhouse, double air inflated poly is the obvious choice. Yes, you can use twin or triple wall polycarbonate sheets, but they don't get as much insulation R value as double air inflated poly, and they cost upwards of 10 times more money. Thickness is key here. Double air inflated poly ends up having a foot or more of air gap as insulation. No glass or polycarbonate sheet comes close to that. And then there's the added air cushion bonus, increasing structural strength in windstorms. The benefits of double air inflated poly has been discussed by many YouTubers like Curtis Stone, the urban farmer, David Gillmore, LDS prepper, and MHPGardner, just to name a few. I include some links below to their YouTube videos on double air inflated poly. Greenhouse poly is easy to buy. There's piles of greenhouse stores online selling quality greenhouse poly, and local greenhouse supply stores all over North America sell good product. Second is inside walls. Whether you're using a peaked roof or curved hoop house, with an air inflated greenhouse, the most affordable, effective insulation is styrofoam. 4x8 hardboard sheets or the like are the best choice here. 3 inches thick are R15, 4 inches is R20. This is a huge insulation factor, capable of insulating the north, east, and west walls, as well as much of the ceiling, to minus 40 degree weather with minimal heat loss. Basically, you secure a 4x8 sheet to the inside wall of the greenhouse, providing an outer wall of double inflated poly, R2 to R5, and then the hardboard styrofoam adding R15 to R20. LDS Prepper is the only person I've seen on YouTube to utilize this cost-effective insulation idea, and I think it's genius. Making the rooftop sheets removable allows them to be removed for spring, fall, and summer, using them only as added insulation for winter when the sun is low in the southern sky. To do it right, insulating these walls isn't enough. Placing a light reflective coating over the styrofoam can increase the amount of usable light for the plants in a reduced sunlight winter day, increasing plant growth. It's cheap to buy and easy to install. The third is the floor. In solar greenhouses, the floor is often ignored, but it can be a huge source of heat loss. I suggest adding 3 to 4 inches of hardboard styrofoam and pouring concrete over it. If you run PEX tubing throughout a concrete floor when you pour it, a variety of heating options are available for minimal investment via radiant heat. By placing 3 inches or more of hardboard styrofoam on the floor and covering it with concrete makes the floor an insulated, active heat sink. Concrete, PEX, and styrofoam insulation are all readily available online or at most any hardware store. In summary, covering the north, east, and west walls with double air inflated poly and hardboard styrofoam insulation on the inside can create an affordable deep winter solar greenhouse from any hoop house kit. Insulating the floor increases heat retention, and adding PEX tubing to a concrete floor adds multiple heating options to take your greenhouse from passive to active. In northern climates, the difference between an active and passive greenhouse is growing lettuce and spinach versus growing tomatoes, cucumbers, and eggplants in December, January, February, and March. I'd love to hear your comments. Please post your ideas below and have fun upgrading your 3-season hoop house to a profitable 4-season growing machine. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for future updates. Don't just hit the subscribe button. Also hit the little bell icon that exists beside the subscribe button. That bell tells YouTube these are the kind of videos you want to see more of, and for YouTube to suggest more on this topic for you. Have a great day.